Hello dear students, hope you are keeping well at home. So here we are for class 7th English 2nd, and this is your English 2nd book Mulberry. So the first chapter of this book is the three questions. The three questions is a short story written by Leo Tolstoy. Leo Tolstoy is a Russian writer, one of the most famous writers, and is known for his novel War and Peace. So here in this story, there are three main characters: a king with three questions, a hermit, a non-religious man, and a wounded person, an enemy. So this story revolves around the life of a king with his three questions. So these three questions are: what was the right time to begin something, who were the right people to listen, and what was the most important thing to do. So before going beyond the story, we should know why the king wanted to seek these three questions. Before moving forward, we will be focusing for this thing, that why is he searching for the answers for these three questions? Think about it, students. There must be some reason behind that, why he wants to get the answer of these questions. Now, the reason is, he thinks if he gets answer to these three questions, he will never fail in his life. His kingdom will never fail, and he will be successful in every field. So here, we have mentioned the questions, three questions, and at the same time, the king sent his messengers throughout his wisdom to ask the answer of these questions, and also decided to give the rewards, to award the person or the people who will give the satisfactory answer to all these three questions. So many wise people came and give the advice and give the answers, their own different answers, but nothing helped to the king, because the king was not satisfied any of the answer of any person. So here the king was very disappointed. Many people came and give their answer, then also king was not satisfied with their different answers. So at last, king decided to go and meet with the hermit. So here hermit, in the second character, a hermit is introduced as an old religious man. So hermit was known for his wisdom. He was an old man and very religious person, and he lived in a forest. And he lives a very simple life. So to interact with the hermit, as we told you that the hermit was a very simple person and a poor man and a religious person. So to meet with the hermit, the king also disguised himself as the hermit. He put on the simple clothes and leave his bodyguards behind and went to the hermit as it is. So the king was there with the hermit to ask his questions, but what happens? Hermit didn't answer or react anything on his questions and continued to digging. So what happened later on? The king was not having any option to do. Then the king asked to provide some help to the hermit, as the hermit was an old person and he was unable to dig anymore. Then the king asked for some help to the hermit. So here the hermit, old man, gave the sword to the king and asked what he want to do. So then king started digging, continuously digging, digging and digging. Then king stopped and again asked the question to the hermit. But the same thing, repeated again. The hermit didn't answer anything, and as the king was not having any option to do, then he again started to dig the soil. Then in the scene, the entry of a wounded person. The wounded person came, and both the person, both the king and a hermit, went to see the wounded person, and king took the wounded person in the cottage of a hermit. Then the king helped in dressing his wound again and again, because the blood was releasing from the body continuously. So the king played a very important role in bonding the person, curing the person from his wounds. So here, after some time, the wounded person came in his consciousness and asked for a water. King provided clean water and look after him. After that, the sun sets at that time, and after drinking the water, wounded person became unconscious because he felt relaxed and slept. As well as the king was also tired since he was working from the very morning of the day. So he was also tired and slept there only. So it is a very big thing that a king was sleeping in the cottage of a hermit. So next day, what happened to the next day? The wounded man walked away and asked the king for his forgiveness. The wounded person asked the king for his forgiveness. Why he was asking? Because actually a wounded person was the enemy of the king. Why he was enemy? Because at a time king has captured his property, and now he came back to take the revenge by the king. So here, but now at a time the wounded person was saved by the king. That is why he leave the thought of killing the taking revenge by the king, and asked the king to serve him. Then the king asked the whole story. Then the wounded person said he was waiting in the way for the return to the king, to the palace, and wanted to take a revenge. And one of the soldier recognized and punished him very badly. Next, what happens? That we have already discussed here. So now the wounded person promises to serve the king. Then the king became very happy. His heart was satisfied, and he also promised to the wounded person, not now wounded person, that person, he will return all his property. Then king again looking for the hermit. Before going, the king thought that at least once I should again ask my questions from the hermit. So again the king started to ask the question by the hermit. The hermit was sowing seeds in the bags that had been dug the day before. Then the bags hermit to answer his questions. King bags again and again to the hermit to answer the question. Then what the hermit replied? The hermit replied, "You have already been answered. You have already been answered." Then he took the seed back and reminded to the king. And reminded to the king what has happened in the early, at the early day. So here the hermit replied, "Remember then, there is only one time, that is right now. It is the most important time because it is the only time when we have any power. The most important person is the one with whom you are at a particular moment. No one knows whether you will ever meet anywhere else in the future. The most important thing to do is to do good, because for that purpose alone are we sent into this life. So here the king received the answer. What was the right time to begin something is now. As the hermit explained that yesterday, if you went without helping me in the way, you will be killed by your enemy, and you will be no more. Then secondly, who were the right pupil to listen? The right pupil to listen is that who is with you at a time. As I was with you at that time. And what was the most important thing to do? What is the most important thing? Is to do good. To do good. As you do good with your enemy, the wounded person, then he also became your servant. He wants to serve you. Earlier he wants to kill you. Now as you do good for him, he also wants to serve you. So here, we think that you have understood this chapter. I hope that you have learned this chapter, and I hope that these answers not only help to the king, but they are going to help you also in your day-to-day life, because these are the important questions in our life, in which our life revolves around. Actually, these are not the answers of the questions of the king only. These are the lesson taught by the Leo Tolstoy to us. So here, this is the homework time, students. In homework, you have to read out the chapter at once or twice, and then you have to pick out the difficult words and write the word meaning in your